Righto, g'day you absolute legends. Welcome back to another one. So in this one, it's all about power. Now, you guys can tell by the thumbnail, we are going to be looking at our 12-volt system in the canopy. So let's not muck around. Let's get straight into it and show you what we've got. Righto, so I'm going to split this video into three parts. I'm going to split it into the battery, the charging, and the accessories. So I'll leave timestamps down in the description box below if you guys want to check out or jump to any part in particular. But first up, let's start with the battery. So when it comes to the battery of our system, we run a really basic and easy system. We run one lithium battery, and that is the iTech 120X Pro. Now, just a couple of very quick specs on the battery. The 120X Pro is a full 120 amp hour usable capacity. It's got a recommended charge current of anywhere between 1 amp and 60 amps, a maximum charge current of 100 amps. It actually matches a lead acid or an AGM style battery. The battery's also got a continuous discharge rate of 150 amps or 175 amps for 5 minutes. It's got a peak discharge, so an absolute maximum discharge of 270 amps for up to 5 seconds. Now, you can also series or parallel these things up with four batteries in total. So you can parallel two rows of two, or you can series up four batteries in series and make a 48 volt battery bank, which makes this thing really versatile. And that's what we really love about it. We can use this in a lot of different ways. All right, so we'll move on to our charging gear, and we'll start off with solar charging. So you guys know that I love my Victron gear. I've had this now for about 3 or 4 years. It's the Victron Smart Solar Charge Controller. Victron make a range of different solar charge controllers from 5 amps all the way up to 100 amps. This one just suited us the best, a 20 amp charger for the solar gear that we run. We were never going to get any more than about 20 amps. We'll run through a couple of features of the charge controller. There are way too many to list out here, but I'll leave a link in the description box below where you guys can go and check out all the specs and all the features of these little units. It has awesome monitoring. So the Victron Connect app can link all of your Victron gear with the app. Now, everything works through Bluetooth, really, really simple, really easy to read, easy to digest, and it's all real-time monitoring. Obviously, a really good feature is that it is a genuine MPPT solar charge controller, meaning that it's always tracking that maximum power point of energy and putting in the maximum power that it can. Now, with the MPPT, this thing really comes into its own in shady and overcast conditions. This really does hunt and go out of its way to try and find a higher power point to pump into your battery. So the efficiency that the controller converts solar energy into electricity is the highest that I've seen on the market so far. Granted, I haven't seen every solar charge controller, but that was obviously a big selling point for me as well. Now, this one might be the biggest selling point for me. It is completely and 100% customizable. So Victron calls it the flexible charge algorithm. Now, you can change your float voltage, your absorption voltage, and your bulk charge voltage, which is a massive feature for any solar charge controller. If your battery was to someday just die and you went with another brand, your solar charge controller might not perfectly match up to that battery. With the Victron one, you can perfectly match it for any specs that your battery carries. All right, so knowing how we charge everything with solar, let's jump over and have a look at the DC-DC charger. Again, we run Victron Energy. We run the Victron Orion TR Smart DC-DC charger. This unit is the 12-12-30. Victron do a bunch of different versions of this as well. They do 12 volt, 24 volt, I believe all the way up to 100 amp chargers as well. But this is the 30 amp charger, and it is an absolute weapon. We've got the non-isolated version, meaning that our canopy 12 volt system and our engine 12 volt system are tied in and grounded using the same ground, which is the chassis. But when it comes to accessories, I built this system with one job in mind, and that was to be able to run the whole canopy as an off-grid installation with no intervention from 240 volts and not reliant on driving the car if I could help it. So with that being said, this is what's powered every day in the whole ute, purely running off the battery, solar charge, and DC-DC when I need to. So you can see just down here next to the battery, we've got just some 12 volt and some USB stuff just for charging some gear. So I've got drone batteries and GoPro batteries and stuff charging over here at the moment. Other side of the fridge, I've got the inverter. So we've just got the King's 1500 watt inverter. This thing has been a pretty solid unit too, if I'm being honest with it. So obviously I've pushed this thing past its 1500 watts a few times, but you know, never died when it was not supposed to, so it's been awesome. We've got the double outlets on this side. I've just got a 2 meter extension cord plugged in permanently, and that just runs along the back of the drawer, tucks down the side and goes over there, and we'll see that over there in a minute. Straight above that, we've got the step up converter. If we're parked up and we're running a little bit low on power, I can unplug the travel buddy, plug it into the secondary side of the step-up converter, plug my battery Anderson plug into the primary side of the step-up converter, and run the travel buddy through here. Now that will bump the voltage up to just under 15 volts, which is exactly what it's designed to run off. Does suck a lot more power, but you know, that's the trade-off you have. You use more power, but at the same time, you cook your food faster as well. So right, after that, we've just got some lights. These are just little strip lights all around the canopy. So I've got three of these in here. Got one on this side, one over the other side, and one at the back as well. These came standard with the canopy. They're made by Labcraft, and they've just got individual little switches up here, which they work really well. They light up the inside of the canopy really great. I actually wouldn't mind getting a couple more of these and putting them on the doors, just to throw some light outside the canopy as well. But for what they are, they do a great job. This one's kind of a funny one, but I didn't want to go drilling holes in the roof of my canopy. So what I worked out and what I came up with was I'll run my solar panel cables back through the muller vent in the roof. Now, these vents don't let any water in. They're sealed up with Sikaflex all the way around on the top. So I thought, well, that's probably a better cable penetration than I was gonna make with a drill and a gland. So that's actually the cable for my solar panel that comes back in through the headboard and pops back out in the fuse block. But that's all I could really come up with. I didn't wanna go drilling too many holes in the roof of the canopy. So anyway, we'll swing around this side and we'll have a look at what power we've got running over this side. Obviously, we'll start with the big one. It's the fridge. It's the 85 litre King's fridge. And it's been a pretty good fridge. Nothing's really gone wrong with it that I didn't cause or that I couldn't fix in about 10 minutes of fault finding. So it's been really good. I'll give you a quick look inside. It's probably a mess in there, but loads of space. There's not too many features with it, but it's a good little fridge. And oh, mate, the best part about it, having that freezer space up there is so good. Anyway, that's about it for that. Not really part of the 12 volt system, but still probably my favorite little feature. Yeah, it runs off electricity. It's got a battery in it. My little JBL speaker. I don't know why I love this so much, but it's just really handy to have a little bit of Velcro on the back, stick it up there, and I can play music whenever I want, which is really cool. Now, when it comes to the 12 volt stuff, we didn't actually run any 12 volt over this side, but I'm in two minds whether to do it now, because as I mentioned over the other side, I want to put some more lighting in on these doors. So I think that's probably going to happen very soon. But apart from that, we don't really need any 12 volt on this side just yet. And I'll show you why. That little 2 meter extension cord in the inverter pops up just inside the drawer here. And I've got a 240 volt double adapter. Usually I just stick that there and it doesn't go anywhere. Obviously it's nice and tight. This is pretty much what we use to charge all of our camera stuff. If we don't do it on the other side, we'll do it here. Our camera stuff, iPads and things like that for the kids, which is really handy with 240 volts. We usually just take a few of those USB adapters and we'll plug them in and run them off 240. Stuff seems to charge faster. Now that 240 volts would be really annoying if I had to walk around the other side every time I wanted to turn it on. So down here, I've just got the King's remote inverter switch. I think these things are about 30 bucks from King's, and it's just simple. Turns on the inverter over the other side and powers up all your 240 that you've got hooked in. And then it's just straight back off again as well. So that's how we're controlling the power on this side. We just run 240 over to this side and all the 12 volt stays over there, which is actually working out pretty well for us. I think we're gonna keep on running with that. We haven't really had any dramas when it comes to needing more outlets or needing more power, apart from the light. So that's probably the only thing we're gonna change is just the lighting on this side. Like I said, the travel buddy over here is at the moment just running straight off the secondary battery. So about 13 volts, give or take. And that hasn't had any drums whatsoever. That's been awesome. Usually we only use this when we are driving. So it works really well just to have it running straight off the secondary battery. But if we are pulled up somewhere, we'll plug it into the step-up converter. Haven't really had it on there enough to know if it's the step-up converter is good for it or not. I've had a lot of questions of people asking me about the step-up converter. Has it mucked around with the travel buddy? Is it making the element struggle? Has it done any damage to it? I haven't really used it enough to be able to give a real definite answer, but if anything was to ever go wrong, I will jump on and tell you guys as fast as I can. Now, I do just quickly want to thank iTech World. They did send this battery out to me about 8 months ago, and I have been doing a very long and in-depth review of this battery. So that one's going to be coming up very soon and showing the good, the bad, all the bits and pieces about that battery, all the details that you guys might like to know if you're in the market for one of these iTech 120X Pros. Now, I've done this whole setup myself. I wouldn't suggest that if you don't have any knowledge of electrical systems. If you've got any doubts, take it to an auto sparky and they'll be able to help you out. And there you have it, guys. That's pretty much the rundown of our 12-volt system. Like I said at the start, it was going to be a pretty basic and simple system. Now, that works really well for us, but I want to know what you guys think. Leave it in the comments what you guys think, because I'm always really curious and really excited to hear what you guys have to say about the setup. So if you've stuck around this long, guys, thanks heaps for watching. If you've got something out of this video, remember to leave it a like and hit that subscribe button so you don't miss a beat. Now, if you want to see more about the canopy or any of the build series, check out the playlist up on screen now, and I'll see you guys over there.